Good morning, guys, and welcome to Cassie's Bump Date. Today is her 38 weeks. I have her phone right here. I know she's got all the notes that I need to talk about.
Wait, what are you doing?
I'm starting your bump date, sweetie.
You're not starting my bump date. Get out of my chair.
No, I want to do your bump date today.
Get out of my chair.
I want to tell them how I'm feeling that you're pregnant.
That's not how this works. Get out of my chair.
All right, then. Here you go.
Maybe you could do it with me, but you got to sit in that chair. This is mine.
She's kicking me out, guys.
Anyways, guys, welcome back to my bump date. Today, I'm 38 weeks pregnant, and I thought I'd have my husband come do the one and only bump date with me.
Maybe it could be the last one. We don't know yet.
It could be the last one, guys. I'm 38 weeks pregnant, and I was like, you know what, Carlos? You haven't been in any of my bump dates, so I want you to be in this one. So here he is.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
I'm here to hold the watermelon for her.
Yep. Jackson, this week is the size of a mini watermelon. I don't think that's true at all, though. I think he's like this big.
A seedless mini watermelon.
Ooh, we're going to eat that later. We're going to eat Jackson's
fruit. It's an organic one, not the GMO one.
So I think he's bigger than that. But you know, you guys know my beef with the fruits, okay?
The fruits are dumb. When she told me the list of fruits, I'm like, oh, how does it go from this to this?
Doesn't make any sense. We don't question it anymore.
Okay.
He's the size of a watermelon today, and last week it was something else, okay? Okay, anyways, 38 weeks pregnant, guys, and the title for this is No More Sleep for This Mama, because I am not sleeping anymore.
She is not lying. She is not sleeping anymore. She's waking up before me now.
I am waking before him.
That has never happened.
Nope, and I'm in the middle of the night, grunting, and I'm moaning and making loud noises because I'm upset. But I'll get jumping into that a little bit later about what's been going on. First, let's talk about Jackson this week.
Okay.
He is humongous. I think he weighs now 7 pounds.
He feels humongous.
He feels humongous, but also in my What to Expect app, I think it says that he should weigh 7 pounds now.
7 pounds? Wow.
Yeah.
I think he's definitely over 7 pounds.
I think he weighs more than that. I think he at least weighs 7.5 pounds personally. They also say that he is 19 to 20 inches long. Who knows? That might be true, might not be.
22 inches long.
Yep. 22. Wow, Carlos is making some big predictions here, guys.
His eyes are blue, gray, or brown. They're blue.
Maybe.
They're blue.
But once they're exposed to light, they might change color or shade. And by age 1, I think by like 6 months though too, we'll know his true color.
They're going to be either blue or green.
Blue or green. Carlos is very headstrong that he's going to have blue eyes.
I keep telling Cassie he's going to have one blue eye and one light brown eye.
Now, I want you guys to leave in the comments what color do you guys think Jackson's eyes are going to be, because Carlos and his family does have blue eyes.
Both of my grandmas have blue eyes.
So the gene is in there somewhere, which means it's not completely impossible. But
and I was born with blue eyes, but I lost them.
And they turned brown. So the odds,
light brown.
The odds are not in our favor, but they are there somewhere.
Yeah.
And Carlos's eyes are not super dark brown, so we'll see. But I got pretty blue eyes, so I got not like I'm not saying they're pretty. I meant they're like pretty blue, like they're really blue eyes. I wasn't calling myself pretty.
They are pretty, though.
They are pretty. Thank you, though. Here's what else is going on with Jackson. It says that his lungs have strengthened and that his vocal cords have developed, which means he is ready to communicate through wails and cries. So if he came out right now, he would be ready to yell at us and scream at us just
and
like Cece does. Right, Cece?
Or cry. Good girl.
Good girl. That's what Jackson wants to do, too, once he's out here. Anyways, obviously, we know that Jackson is doing very well inside. We always have our NSTs, and he always, like, you know, passes them very well. But let's talk about how Cassie's been feeling this week.
Okay. You sure you want to talk about me first?
Yeah, actually,
I've been feeling great, though.
What have been your symptoms, Carlos? What have your...
No, just go to yours. I've been feeling good, yeah.
Your pregnancy
symptoms? I'm just here to support you.
Okay. Well, I'd say this week has, once again, like I said, has been one of the hardest weeks of this pregnancy. I say it every time. Each week gets harder, and the 38th week is really hard. I am having such a hard time sleeping now. I no longer sleep at all. I think that's what you say. I no longer sleep at all. That's what you say?
Yeah, she doesn't sleep at all.
Of course,
I think she gets like 3 hours of sleep now.
I do sleep, but I've been waking up in a lot of pain, a lot of pressure. Baby just doing stuff. His kicks officially are painful. They are not. Oh, cute. It is. Ow. 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 Oh, my. I thought.
Yeah. You've been having a hard time breathing also.
Yeah. I've been having a hard time breathing. I don't think he's dropped. So he's still suffocating me up ahead.
He likes to kick your rib.
He likes to kick my ribs.
Specifically, I think it's your right one you said.
Oh, yes. Right ones. And always at night. Specifically when I go to bed. When I go to bed, the ribs are the best place for him.
But he's just preparing you for when he comes out. He's going to tell you. He's like, you're going to get very little sleep.
Yeah. I'm okay with that though. I would love if he was here. And the sleep I was not getting was like you know, not painful.
And I can't wait to help you with that.
Yes, like I said, guys, I just want to have the baby here so bad so that it's not just me in charge of the baby. I want us to be in charge of the baby.
Yes.
Anyway, so yeah, it's been a pretty hard week for sleeping wise, but just in general, I had just been having so much cramping, pressure. I've been still having those contractions that mean nothing. And so all of that just leads to me not having my baby. And so it's been a rough week. Whenever I go to my NSTs and I come back to the car, Carlos just looks at me and he knows I'm pouting because they once again just tell me, you're doing good, keep going. And I'm like, keep going.
Did you tell them that you were not dilated when they checked you last time?
I think I did. I have zero dilation, but I am getting rechecked for that this week and we'll see if I've made any progress. I'm officially in labor mode, guys.
Cassie has been trying so hard to get this baby out. She's been doing the curb walking. We've been walking every day. She's been bouncing on her ball and she's been doing her little workouts that I don't know what they are.
You don't know what they are, but
she's just moving her hips a lot and
I'm trying to get this baby out.
Nothing seems to be working. This kid is way too comfortable in there.
Yep, at the end of the day, it seems like Jackson has his own plan and anything I do, maybe it'll help eventually, but it definitely is not encouraging any kind of labor at the moment. And I don't see it really doing much.
And then also Cassie has been in her app and she's reading about these women having their baby. She's so jelly.
So jealous. They have these cute little babies and they have them before me. They'll be like 38 weeks one day, had my baby. And I'm like, must be nice. Must be nice. 37 weeks, my baby's perfect. Good for you. But, but who's counting? I'm not me, though.
You just made it way too comfortable in there for him.
Yep, I gave him a pretty good, awesome living space in here, and I think he's going to be using up the rent until at least April. He paid through March. So I think this next week, guys, we are really trying to finish everything that we need to have this baby, because he could come any day now. Obviously, we joke around and say he's not going to come, but he could come any day now. Whoa, the door just slammed.
Oh, wow.
That scared me. And one of the things that we did this week was we did my belly cast finally. And it actually went out. If you guys haven't watched it, go check it out. And it came out so cute. I can't wait to put Jackson in it for newborn photos.
That was last week. Do you think he still fit in it?
I don't know. I'll have to see. Guys, but before I leave for the hospital, the last thing I want to do is like put the belly cast on and see if it still fits. See if I've gotten like way bigger before then. But if you guys didn't watch the belly cast, it was a really special video that Carlos got to do with me, my mom and sister, and it was just really special. So if you guys want to check it out, we'll have it linked up in the iCard. But yeah, what's on our list to do this week? Like everything basically,
actually,
right?
We pretty much did everything. I got the car detailed. Mm-hmm. There's no dog hair in there.
But we have actual things we have to do,
I just
though.
Need to install the car seat.
And we need to put up like the pack and play and the rockers. I want to set up his bassinet in our room and get things going for that.
The bassinet's already done. It's right here. We just need to move it to the room.
I'm going
to
move it to the room. I actually really want to get a spot set up for next to the bed. I feel like I've said that before, guys, but I still haven't done
it. But we are ready to go to the hospital if she needs to go.
Yes. And I have like a little list of things that like to not forget before you go. Like, you know, I've been thinking about like bringing my wedge and making sure we both bring pillows now, because I heard the pillows suck and the blankets suck. And so I'm trying to make it a comfortable experience. And so there is like a list of things that I'm like, we need to bring this when it's time. But we'll see how much time we have. We'll probably forget something.
Oh, we will, but I could always come back.
The one thing we don't want to forget is the camera. Another like newer symptom, or at least something that's just been getting a lot worse this week, is acid reflux and heartburn. It seems like everything I eat, everything I do, not everything, but a lot of things, I've been getting like a lot of acid reflux and heartburn, and I was not getting that kind of stuff before, almost to the point where it's actually hard for me to go to bed because it just feels like there's a burning in my throat. Maybe he's gonna come out with a full head of hair though.
Probably.
That's what they say it means. They say if you have acid reflux and heartburn, it means they got hair, and the more acid reflux,
well, we know we saw hair. Some hair.
And that was forever ago. That was 6 weeks ago when he had hair, when it was a little bit.
I'm going to predict that he is going to come out with like a full set of hair.
I think he'll have a full set of hair, black hair actually. And one of the last things I'm going to touch on is that personally, I think my belly is starting to look a little bit scarier. I think it's gotten a little more like, ooh, that looks really uncomfortable. I've been getting some really interesting looks at the stores now where they're like, oh, it looks like you're about to have this baby. And I'm like, I should be. And I do think it's just been getting a lot bigger, a little more scary looking. Sometimes it looks really distorted too because of the way he's sitting. So I think it's a little scarier.
I think it's still cute.
Well, of course, you have to say that.
I don't have to say that.
I won't look. I won't look. Do you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Okay, I freaking knew it. Just kidding. But I do think it's a little bit...
She's getting bigger.
Yeah, it's a little bit bigger. When people see me, they're more like, whoa, You okay? Anyways, guys, I want to show you guys a fun little comparison picture right now. So I have my 38-week picture that I'm going to show you guys right here. It's my 38-week picture I took. And here is my 35-week picture that I want to compare with you guys. Look at the difference in 3 weeks. I think there's a huge difference. But I don't quite know if I've dropped.
Your belly dropped a little bit, but...
A little bit.
Yeah.
But not like, oh, you're carrying low. It's like, you're a little bit lower. And maybe this will be my last bump date, guys.
It could be my last bump date. We don't know yet, but it could be.
It could be. Anyways, guys, that's it for today's bump date. Hope you guys liked it. If you did, smash that thumbs up button. And I will see you guys maybe next week.
Maybe. We don't know yet.
Maybe. Bye, guys.
Bye.